And in no other country on this earth could her story unfold the way it has. From a child of immigrants to big sister to McDonald's worker, there is hope for y'all. District attorney, a wife and mamala to senator to vice president, please welcome Kamala Harris.
Several months later.
The truth is, this is just an epic disaster. This is a $1 billion disaster. Jen O'Malley Dillon promised all of us that Harris would win. She even put videos out saying that Harris would win. I believed her. My donors believed her. And so they wrote massive checks. I feel like a lot of us were misled.
And then, Alexa, I was looking at this, the $1 billion campaign and some of the things they spent, $15 million plus for celebrity event production. They paid Oprah Winfrey's organization $1 million. And they were still asking all of these people to give small dollar donations to the campaign.
The Call Her Daddy example is kind of overall speaking for how the campaign was. It was a lot of smoke and mirrors. There was a lot of celebrity endorsements, free concerts, billed as rallies. There was no substance. And so, you know, the campaign, I think, wanted to coast on vibes, but vibes doesn't pay off your car loans.
Yeah. What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Now, y'all, over the last few days, the Democrats have been reeling, losing their mind as they go through the autopsy of the dead Democratic campaign, trying to figure out who's to blame, who's at fault. Well, one thing that's being uncovered is that those of us who were on the right side of things, those of us who were looking at it analytically, critically, yeah, we were right, y'all. We looked at this woman and her empty speeches. She couldn't speak outside of the teleprompter, couldn't hold an interview, couldn't have a candid conversation. Everything seemed scripted. It seemed like we were being sold a movie screenplay. Well, it turns out, y'all, news is reporting days after the election has been decided, everybody got paid, y'all. Everybody, including Oprah. That's right. It's being reported that Oprah got paid $1 million to do that little sit down with Kamala. And if I was Oprah, I'd be kind of upset, y'all, because she's supposed to be the queen of daytime television. And it seems like the rappers were getting bigger bags than Oprah. Can you believe it? Saw one report that said Meg Thee Stallion got $5 million and all she did was jump up there with her backup dancers and shake her tail feathers. Saw another report that said Beyonce got $10 million to speak for 3 minutes. Well, when you have a campaign that is flush with cash, and then that leads to another rabbit hole, you have to ask, why are so many people donating so much money to this campaign that seems to have no substance? If this woman would have become the president, well, she would have been making all of the decisions, right? So what of these donors who gave her all that money? Well, if you know like I know, you know that this woman is incapable of making presidential decisions on her own, and those big donors who donated to the tune of over $1 billion, they would have been controlling her like a puppet master, having her on a string. Well, I guess we dodged that bullet, and those of us who find ourselves on the right side of things can be thankful to God that Donald Trump will be in the White House. He's already started making his picks. It's gonna work out, y'all. It's gonna be good. And we won't have to deal with payoffs because Donald Trump don't need your money, but evidently, y'all, Oprah does.
Hey, Oprah, good morning. How are you, darling? You're looking very good. How do you think the election went?
Not talking about the election. Thank you very much.
Oh, is it true that they paid you $1 million for the endorsement for Kamala?
Not true.
Not true, okay.
I was paid nothing, ever.
What do you think about all the celebrities with their mass exodus?
I'm not talking about that.
Do you think Prince Harry's going to lose his visa now that Trump's president? Thank you, Oprah.
Ah, you see the game, y'all? You see the play? Oprah says, I never received any payment personally. Yeah, but what about Harpo Productions? What about your nonprofit? What about perhaps a new LLC that you set up just for this instance? See, it's all kind of ways to play that game, y'all. And these elitists think that regular Americans, everyday Americans are so dumb that we don't know the game. Well, some of us know the game, and some of us play the game, and some of us do our best to teach others the game so they can elevate and create generational wealth like Oprah has. Y'all see that range? Oprah just walking through the neighborhood, looking like what she been through. She looked very different on daytime television, don't she? But there's more, y'all. Can you imagine people like Charlemagne the God? Lenard got paid, y'all. Charlemagne the Lesser Charge may have received a nice little coin for his full-throated endorsement. I mean, Charlemagne went hard. He has several episodes of his podcast where he was inviting folks onto the Breakfast Club, and he was challenging people on the right. I mean, he was standing 10 toes down for Kamala. Yeah, that same Kamala who sat down on the Breakfast Club and told Charlemagne, "I was born black and I'm gonna die black." Y'all remember that? Yeah, that Charlemagne who let her talk that talk, knowing all the while she was a Hindu Indian woman. And see, that's the thing that gets me, y'all, because in this scripting, in this facade, in this mask that they put on this woman before all of the American people, why did they have to choose a mask of blackness? Of all things, the Indians would have been proud. Mindy Kaling was proud until she got rejected. They would have been proud to have the first Indian woman running for president. They would have stood behind her. That Indian vote must not have been strong enough. Those Indian numbers must not have been strong enough because they chose people like Lenard to cape for her, to uphold her mask and veil of blackness and put her out there as a black woman. Well, you see how fast that fell apart?
I think that she should keep calling Donald Trump a fascist. And I think that Americans need to keep looking at the rhetoric of Donald Trump, because I don't know why we're even thinking about electing somebody who's talking about putting people in camps. I don't know why we're talking, or why we want to elect somebody who's talking about mass deportation. I don't know why we're having this conversation which about somebody who wants to terminate the Constitution.
Don't y'all find it strange that now that he's won, they're not calling him a threat to democracy? They're not calling him a fascist. I mean, damn, On Monday, they was just calling him that. I would think that, you know, if you really believe that, then somebody's speech would be about how America effed up and how things are about to be Charlie, really bad.
Even that man
he's
alone.
The most powerful man in the world now.
It just makes you wonder how much of it did they really believe, or how much of it was just politics.
So what does America get for $1 billion wasted? Hopefully we get a $1 billion lesson. Seems to me like that's the best thing we can take away from this entire example. Hopefully we understand that politics is a dirty game. Things are being pitched to us. Things are being sold to us. People are being bought and sold like the stock market. And you can't trust anyone. Politics makes for strange bedfellows. People who were your enemy yesterday might be your friend today, and vice versa. That's why the very vice president of Joe Biden gladly took his place and walked the final mile, the final lap in his shoes. Just say, hey, move him out the way. We backstabbing out here. I'm gonna be the president now. Let me step up. I got $1 billion to spend. Let's throw a little bit over here, throw a little bit over there, give Charlemagne some, give Beyonce some, give Oprah some. Who else wants some? We got money over here.
This election. She's good at raising money and she's good at blowing it. But money can't buy you elections, especially when you spend it like she did. She raked in more than $1 billion and is somehow now in debt. The Washington Examiner dug through her financial statements and gave us a good clue why. Kamala's campaign was getting whacked like a pinata while DC leeches hoovered up all the cash. She spent over $50 million on payroll. Trump's campaign spent less than 10. Another $12 million went to consultants, and $20 million went to their little concerts with Lady Gaga, Katy Perry, Christina Aguilera, Jon Bon Jovi, remember him? They even had to cancel a performance by Alanis Morissette because they were running low on cash. Isn't that ironic? Campaign insiders are mad at the bosses for wasting donor money on concerts instead of ads about, you know, the economy. quote, they said they were spending to zero. I guess they overshot zero. Ads would have gone a lot further than the pricey celebrity endorsements. One campaign source said people were concerned about their own financial issues, not Oprah telling them America won't exist. But it worked out nicely for Oprah. She got her friend Kamala to pay her $1 million to interview her in September. $1 million. Now, if she thought she was saving democracy, she should have done it for free. Kamala scared donors by calling Trump a dictator, got $1 billion, then just gave it to her friends and blew the rest on being a diva. Kamala went on a podcast, remember, Call Her Daddy? But she didn't want to go to their studio in L.A. So she made the host fly to D.C. and used campaign cash to build a fake set in a hotel room. She spent more than $100,000 to build it. That set. See it? Two chairs, a coffee table, and a bookshelf. That's six figures. Now, we looked at the set. We probably could have done it for around $6,000. That's without labor. But where'd the rest of the money go? We don't know. So she's still trying to soak folks for cash. 24 hours after the election, on Wednesday, Democrats got a text from the campaign. Urgent. We need help. Donate now. Help with what? You lost. If this is how she's going to spend her donors' dollars, imagine what she would have done with our taxes.
$1 billion couldn't fool the American people. $1 billion couldn't convince you that gas ain't $6. That butter ain't $3. That eggs ain't $6. Couldn't convince you. And I'm proud of you for that. And I hope that moving forward, you pay more attention to this political space. I know a lot of people have been tuned out. A lot of people don't find this subject matter interesting. Not everybody go to school to get a poli-sci degree. Not everybody finds this stuff entertaining or interesting. I get it. But I hope that you will pay more attention to it because it affects the lives of your families and your children, your loved ones and your friends. It affects your community. And it can affect your community in a very negative way when you allow charlatans to be ushered into place. You gotta wonder, who's behind all this money? What is the motivation? And if they can burn $1 billion, well, what do they expect to get on the back end for that billion? Interesting times we live in, y'all. And I'm glad we have a billionaire president who can't be bought off in that way. Oh, let me know in the comments what you think about this. I'd love to know your thoughts. And don't forget to like the video. Subscribe to the channel and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget. Without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time. Peace.